And a one, two, three, we try again. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, good night, depending on where in the world you're watching this from. Welcome back to another unboxing here on the channel. We're taking a look at the 9-disc deluxe edition of the Tears of the Kingdom soundtrack. This is my second attempt at recording this because the software had a recording error as I was actually getting close to the finish and the footage was unsalvageable. So I would love to say that a lot of this is taking me by surprise for the first time. As you can see, I've already taken it out of the plastic and I wasn't going to dress it back up for the sake of the video and pretend that this is all, wow. So I just thought it will give me an opportunity to kind of get through the overview a bit faster because I know what to expect. And if you were wondering if this was worth it for your own collection, and we'll even compare it to similar recent Zelda releases. So it does come wrapped in plastic. Again, I've taken the plastic off and you've got this dust cover, which tells you about the soundtrack, the 9 discs, the USB drive, which has 15 tracks on it. You can see here on the side, The Legend of Zelda, Tears of the Kingdom original soundtrack. The back of this cover tells you what tracks are on all 9 discs. I won't bother going over it too deeply because every track is in Japanese except for like these last 4, which because they're just like trailer scores and such. But yeah, that's kind of what's on the back here. We flip it over. I can take this little dust cover sheet thing off, hold it up, and set it neatly aside. So here we have the box for the soundtrack itself. I imagine this is what you'd get if you just got it normally. We have a booklet here telling us what songs are on what disc. And then we have the USB pen drive housed in this really just nice packaging. It's very soft, like cardboard velour in a sense. It's just, it's really high quality. So taking these out for a moment, you can see that the Uzoni branding on the box is reflective, similar to the Breath of the Wild branding on merchandise for that game. We've also got like the little details flowing through printed on to sort of give it this old but new look. Side of the box again, Legend of Zelda, Tears of the Kingdom original soundtrack. And then the Japanese logo for the game, because I got this through Amazon Japan, because here in the West, we're not allowed to have nice things. So we set that there for a moment. And then we will open up this. So again, with the Japanese logo, you've got the islands in the sky, this image, and then the red, the sun setting or rising. Giving this nice red and orange hue. It's got this big, very painterly vibe. And you can see this kind of wraps around the whole thing. So if I open this out, you can see it's just one large image, which I think is pretty dang cool. Flipping it over, the discs are broken into 3 sets of 3. Discs 1, 4, and 7 are here on the front. And then behind door number 1, 2, and 3, we get to see discs 2 and 3, 5 and 6, and 8 and 9, respectively. So I'm just trying to try and not get myself, not get face revealed here, but you can see the Zoni Ouroboros there. And then if we open up, it's going to be all the symbols from like the sage's stones and the sage emblems from the game itself. So there's disc 2 and 3. Come over here, there's disc 4. Just close the door. I'll just close the door here. I will open them up because you can probably see there is like another mural behind here, but you can't really see what's happening. I will show them off, but for brevity's sake, that is a Ganondorf and like sort of like calamity magic with him, This one is the draconification of a certain character, and this one, the one on this side, will be Princess Zelda powering the broken Master Sword, but I will show them off momentarily. So if we open this up, there are discs 5 and 6. Close this door, push this forward, there is disc 7, but if I open up this door, there is disc 8 and 9. And I know, I thought the same thing. How does this game, and I thought the same thing with Breath of the Wild, and Breath of the Wild has like 6 or 7 discs as well. I was like, how does this game have that much music? It somehow does. For such a quiet game, it has a lot of music. So look, I'll take the disc, I'll take disc 9 off, we'll work backwards just so I can seal it up as we go. You can see here. Princess Zelda powering up the Master Sword. There's the pedestal that she receives it on at the Temple of Time. Close that over. Open this up. And there is a certain dragon. Not me. Another certain dragon. And then if I open this back up, from there we can see Ganondorf and Calamity Magic, and you can see Rauru there heading off, trying to face him. Surrounded by other warriors, so fun. And then down the bottom, there's like this stuff happening down the bottom as well. And yeah, so it's nice that they were able to include some of like the murals from the start of the game. Then closing that over, I can do that, and then that, and then that just slots very nicely back into the box. The booklet, very nice glossy paper on it. Again, we have the Zonai Ouroboros along with Rauru and Sonya on the front. It's really nice. But the booklet itself is very basic. It really just shows like the disc, the tracks, some big art of the characters, and then some screenshots of the game behind them. There's no mini interview with like the composers. There's no thank you message from the staff, anything like that you would see in other publications like this. So there's disc 2 with Tulin. Disc 3 is the Goron whose name I still don't remember, even though I'm recording this twice, and could have looked up his name in between recordings, but I just don't care for the character, so his name escapes me. Sorry, not sorry. Disc 4, we get this awesome image of Sidon, along with this insert to tell us what tracks are on the USB stick, which I will also be showing off momentarily. Then for disc 5, we have Riju, same awesome art as always. And we have the ghost of Rauru. For disc 6, we have Minoru for disc 7. Hey, cutie. And we have Daddy Dorf here for disc 8. I recently got the 3 amiibo for this game, and I'm like, yeah, I still haven't opened them either. I just have not been getting time to open up all my new stuff. So I figured if I was going to do it, I may as well share it with you guys. Then we have Zelda for disc 9. Great fairies and just other stuff in the background. And then after that, we get this splash art, and the only two characters with new art are Link and Zelda. Like, it's art we've seen before, but it's art that hasn't been used previously in this booklet. And then it's the credits, and that's it. Like, there's no, as I said, like, there's no interview with the composers or anything. There's no thank you message. There's nothing. It's just that. Back of the booklet, Master Sword. So it's, you know, it's very bare bones. But then we come to the reason this was probably 160 euro, including shipping. Thanks, Amazon. Oh yeah, this was expensive. The Legend of Zelda, Tears of the Kingdom, Master Sword USB, copyright Nintendo, not for sale. So, let me open this up. I love it. Like, the emblem here is embossed. It's raised off the cardboard. It's got its own texture. It's great. Let's see if I can get the camera to focus. Kinda. Anyway. Nothing on the back or the sides. If we open it up, we've got the cutest Master Sword I think I've ever seen stuck in this pedestal. This base is resin. I think it's a resin USB stick and pedestal. If I tap on it, you know, it's very clinky. Kind of metal, but not. Like, you can hear it's very plump. You know, very kind of metallic, but not quite. So I think it's like resin. When I first saw the preview images of this, I thought it was going to be a lot fatter, and therefore it looked very silly. I guess it kind of does in a way, because it's just the hilt of the Master Sword stuck in the pedestal here, but it's all, like, I mean, for a pen drive, like, they weren't exactly going to give you a full length Master Sword. But I also do think it's got a very Sword in the Stone aesthetic here, where, like, where the blade would come out of the pedestal entirely as you go. But if you do take it out, this is what it looks like. It's a USB drive. So Fi is currently holding 15 songs for me to pop this into my computer and listen to later. Got a nice rubber grip to just keep it in place. Pop the drive back in. Put it up on your desk or whatever, and it'll be a nice display piece, you know? It does, the one block of solid color actually works in its favor, because it just looks like a little decorative piece, and the engraving of the Hylian crest, also very cool. Weird to see the Triforce, considering, like, I don't even think the Triforce gets a mention in Tears of the Kingdom. It barely got a mention in Breath of the Wild, so seeing the Hylian crest with the Triforce and stuff on, like, that era of Zelda branding is kind of weird in a sense. It's like, you know, the relic that should not be here. But anyway, so I'm gonna drop that back in. I will listen to those tracks on my own time. Bring that out. Pop that back in. And back in with the booklet and the discs it goes. So, as you can see, it is quite sizable. It is going to take up a lot of room on your shelf. It has been made to match other recent releases. We take the Breath of the Wild one, though, which also came with a little USB thing in a, like, I think it was meant to mimic like a cassette tape box, which I think is really cute, but you open it up, it's a little speaker. You plug it in by USB. That just goes in. A 3.5 millimeter jack just goes into that. And then you've got, you know, play, fast forward, rewind. It's a little pin, apparently, but also USB. So not entirely sure how you're meant to... I've never actually tried to hit the button. I don't think I've ever charged this because I was like, when would I use it? But no, it's very dead. Okay, the battery is very dead. I have never used this since I got it. So if it worked, that would have been a miracle. Also a hell of a battery charge for like 5 years or something. So, you know, it also came with a little extra, and I guess that's just what I was showing off. But, and then just the covers mimic each other. So they'll complement each other well when they're sitting next to each other, you know, on your shelf. They'll complement each other well. And then it's just kind of the same setup. It's 5 discs for this game, as opposed to like the 9 for Tears of the Kingdom. Make of that what you will. Hard to imagine Tears of the Kingdom. Well, I suppose Tears of the Kingdom has the depths, right? So that's probably why. It also came with this clear file that the Tears of the Kingdom one didn't. I love this art so much. This art, like, this art was also like kind of part of the reason I got the deluxe Breath of the Wild soundtrack, but because they just weren't printing it on anything else at the time, and I love it so much. And then the booklet, you can see it's a bit thicker than the Tears of the Kingdom one, right? So same idea though. Artwork, characters, artwork of the characters, what discs the tracks are on, you know, all that stuff. But then there's like an interview, right? And that's what I love about this, about these, is that you normally get this cool interview that gives you insight into how the music was made. So I was more let, and then you get the credits. So a more interview. So I was kind of let down that the Tears of the Kingdom one is just so basic bitch by comparison, because I'd have loved to know what went into, you know, the music for Tears of the Kingdom thematically, what directions they were given, things like that, you know. So it does feel like a bit of a letdown. But you know, it is what it is. I don't, like, it couldn't have cost them that much extra to print an extra couple of pages in the booklet for this one. But anyway, if you're gonna have them on your shelf, they complement each other well. But yeah, the Tears one is like, Jesus Christ, is like, it's this and a half, it's this and a bit, right? Oh, like, whoa. These two will also complement another recent release. Not this one. Not the Link's Awakening one. Link's Awakening, again, I haven't opened it up, but they just went, here's the remake music, here's the Game Boy version music, have fun. There was no special version of this in the vein of these. But they did do one for Skyward Sword, which again is another chunky unit of a release. And if we open it up, same idea again. Artwork that wraps around. This also had 5 discs. But it came with a booklet. Right? And then, right, this is even more basic. Right? Disc 1, disc 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, then I got Nintendo points or something, and a warranty for the music box that came with this. Not a warranty, I think it's a warranty for the music box. But then again, just a look back, also in English, a look back at The Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword. Rise, Link, the time has come for you to awaken. You are fated to have a hand in a great destiny. All of that's from the English version. All of this is in Japanese. But like, you know, they still tried. There was still effort put into it, right? Compared to the Tears booklet. And maybe this is why I feel so let down. Because, you know, I've seen that they can put effort into these things, so maybe I just came to expect it. But then you get a little history of the Master Sword blurb, and it shows you the different evolution stages of the sword in-game. And then you get the credits. So, like, there's no interview, but this little extra history of the Master Sword segment is lovely, and it even takes you through other games like Wind Waker and Ocarina, and then timeline shenanigans. And so I think that's why I feel mostly let down by the booklet in the Tears release, because it is just bare bones, basic, you know, here's the songs and a bit of art. And then Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword, the Skyward Sword version of the Hylian Crest with the Loftwing. Open it up. And as you can see, I've never used this either. But it came with a little music box that you wind up and it plays Zelda's lullaby. So can we do it? Oh. I don't even know if this is loud enough to come through. I might just have to talk so you guys can hear it, but it's very cute. So that's what I love about these collector's edition like soundtracks that they put out, because there's always some neat little extra. I think the music box is certainly a bit more inspired than a USB drive, but the USB drive is just cute. It'll look nice on a shelf or a desk or something. And 15 FLAC tracks. Can't complain. FLAC is a great music. You know, it's a great quality, you know, higher than MP3, there's more fidelity. It's like vinyl for digital songs, right? You know, people say vinyl is better than, that's not how that works. People say vinyl is better than CD, right? And that's what FLAC is, like, it's basically comparatively vinyl for MP3s. So yeah. And that's just all gonna go back into its box. And there we go. So the Tears one is about the Tears one is the same size as the Skyward Sword one. If you're just looking for like how much, if you're wondering how much room it's gonna take up on your shelf. These two are the same size, even like these boxes are the same. This is narrower than this, even though there's more discs in it, which I think is funny. So I think this one might actually be wider than this, like just with that in mind. But you can see that's on par with this, and this has more discs in it because those doors are like TARDISes. Those inner doors for the CDs are like fucking TARDISes. But I know I've done a lot of griping over the booklet, but I am still happy with the collection as a whole, and it'll look great, you know, sitting up next to these on my shelving. You know, and just when you have that sort of notion of, gee, I want to listen to the main theme of this, or I just want to put on some nice peaceful Zelda music while I work or while I'm writing or while I'm doing something else. And you know, just having this to be able to pull down off the shelf, because physical media, you should always make sure you have physical media where possible. It's just nice that I have the options that if I'm in the mood for Tears of the Kingdom music, great, pick a disc and go, you know? This doesn't really compare. But guys, I'm gonna leave it there. I think I've talked your ears off long enough. I hope you've enjoyed this little video, just kind of going through what is on this. Maybe you'll consider picking it up for your own collection. If I remember, I'll put a link in the description down below to where I got it. But it's probably not going to be that hard to find. CD Japan, Play Asia, Amazon Japan, you know. You probably won't have any trouble finding it. So, but I'll put the link I used anyway down below if I remember while I'm uploading this. And I'm gonna leave it there. Thank you so much for watching. The next unboxing video on the channel will either before the Cloud, Aerith, or Sephiroth Adorable Arts figurine. So look forward to that. There's more fun stuff coming, and yeah, thanks for being here. I'll see you all soon, and ta-ra for now. Bye! Press the end button.